Hello and welcome to Film of the Century of the Week. I'm George Roth and I'm the host of this program here at Access Channel 5 in Mayville. I shall be presenting films and short films that are within the public domain of the United States, and new segments and films shall be added each week. We broadcast twice daily, every day, at 4 o'clock p.m. and 10 p.m. Today, we switch to the genre of Japanese films. Now, the Japanese film industry had been drastically shaped in its post-war years by a group of new romantic types of filmmakers like Akira Kurosawa, Seijun Suzuki, and Yasuhiro Ozu. Samurai films and gangster dramas took hold in the country during the post-war era, as did science fiction films. Starting with the original Godzilla, released in 1954 by Toho Pictures, the genre of science fiction films, or tokusatsu eiga, took Japan by storm. Mysterious invading aliens, gigantic roving monsters, and robot defenders of the Earth were in full vogue by the time that the 1950s came to a close. By the time the 60s came around, studios other than Toho decided to cash in on the genre. With giant reptiles being a good starting point, Daiei Film Company Limited decided to create their own monster in Gammera, a giant turtle creature that feeds on heat and breathes fire. For Daiei, this was an out-of-character move, as they had mostly been involved with samurai films till that point. Famously, they had distributed Kurosawa's Rashomon in 1950. With the script in place, Gammera was directed by Noriaki Yuasa, who was an enthusiastic and charismatic director and brought his style to the film, as well as its first six sequels. Yuasa was very friendly and open about his role in these gigantic monster movies, attending the G-Fest conventions in the United States on a semi-regular basis until his death from stroke in 2004. Due to its low budget, the first Gammera film was filmed in black and white. The film revolved around a scientific team in the Arctic that witnesses a dogfight between Soviet and American aircraft. One Soviet plane is shot down and is carrying a nuclear bomb, which explodes and awakens the gigantic Gammera from his long slumber in the Arctic ice. The rest of the film is a race against time as scientists and military try every single plan as possible that they can to defeat the angry turtle monster before he destroys Tokyo. Like most Japanese sci-fi films of the era, Gammera was edited and dubbed into English by small production companies. It was also retitled as Gammera the Invincible. Early versions of the film featured entirely new scenes edited into the film featuring American actors that took up a good majority of the non-monster scenes. This version, however, is the international version released and restored by Sandy Frank Productions in 1985. So I hope you'll enjoy this Japanese monster movie gem as we sit back for Gammera the Invincible.
Here we are. It looks wild, huh?
You can say that again.
Let's start unloading the equipment.
We won't need everything at once.
Hello, how do you do, sir? We are from the exploration ship Chidori Maru.
I know.
Look up there!
The devil's bird!
The engines are silent because they're avoiding the fighter planes. I wonder whose they are.
The war even comes to this Eskimo village. Soon there won't be any peace anywhere.
Captain, the ice is getting thicker. Shall we keep going?
Of course. We must get through.
Do you think Dr. Hidaka will learn anything from the Eskimos?
I certainly hope he does.
Yes.
What?
Captain, look, what is that?
Thank you. unidentified aircraft, sir.
Have you spotted anything on your radar screen?
No, sir. It must be coated with anti-electric wave paint, sir.
Okay. Operator, hand me the mic.
Yes, sir.
Calling all planes, fighter planes, based in the Arctic Ocean. This is your commander calling. Over.
This is the strategic fighter. Over.
There is an unidentified aircraft flying on course 84.27 degrees north latitude and 176.58 degrees east longitude. Intercept and escort it to the base. If it resists, shoot it down.
Roger.
Captain, will they attack us?
I doubt it.
Looks like that airplane carried atomic weapons.
Yeah, I think you're right. Did you see the force of that explosion as it hit the ground? What a great story.
Be careful, though. Don't go into that area. There's radiation there.
Somebody is sending out radio jamming waves.
What are you doing about it? Find out where it's coming from.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I heard there were strange giant turtles on the Arctic continent. Do you know anything about them?
No, nothing at all.
Dr. Hidaka, the Third World War might begin any minute and we'll all be killed. Why should we bother about giant turtles?
Yes, maybe you're right. Is the radio working? Can you contact the ship?
I've been trying, but the atmospheric conditions are bad and I can't make contact.
We're cut off. What'll we do?
All right, then, let's go back.
Right.
Yes.
Goodbye, Chief. Thank you.
Bye. Mr. Hidaka?
Yes?
This is the legendary stone handed down from our fathers.
Then is this the turtle that lived on the Arctic continent?
Yes. It is the devil's envoy, Gammera.
Gammera? Then my theory was right after all.
But you see that wave-like pattern? It doesn't match the other carvings.
Excuse me, Chief. Where is it from?
I don't know. I know. It brings evil.
We may have hit upon something very important.
Could it be a creature that's not known?
It's hard to say. There are waves around it. It must be aquatic.
Do you think that it could be a prehistoric creature or from another planet?
Anything's possible.
What do you think it is, Captain?
I don't know. I've never seen anything like it. Very strange.
It looks like it's a kind of a sea creature.
Or monster.
Commander, a message from the ship. Emergency, they're abandoning ship.
The wheel, everybody off, I said everybody off, let go.
Emergency, SOS, SOS.
Message from a Chidori Maru.
Huge turtle. 60 meters. What's going on around here?
I don't know, sir. Looks like a huge turtle made its appearance.
Well, I will have to order up the observation planes to find out what's going on.
Where the research ship went down, but can't see either the crew or the giant turtle.
Good afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, we have special news and an extra guest, Dr. Hidaka.
Good afternoon, Doctor. Good afternoon. Please sit down.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Hidaka, a Japanese zoologist, will now comment on the great turtle which made his appearance in the Arctic Ocean recently. Dr. Hidaka, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's believed that there used to be a very great continent in the northern Arctic regions. An extraordinary creature lived there, whose name was Gammera, a giant turtle, a monster of another age, And this is a legendary stone handed down by the Eskimos. This Gammera has been hibernating for thousands of years, imprisoned under an iceberg. However, you revived after the iceberg exploded as the result of an atomic bomb. Gammera then destroyed the research ship we were using, killing every one of the crew. We three were not on board then. And so, my daughter and I were spared, and also a young reporter. I warn all of you that Gammera is violent and must therefore be approached with the utmost caution. But also, Gammera is expected to die shortly due to radioactivity. And so, I pray that this will happen soon for the peace of the entire world, and that the monster will vanish once and for all in the depths of the sea, forever. Only, as a zoologist, I greatly regret the loss of a creature originating in the dawn of time. Thank you.
I never saw a ball of fire before that changed its course. Ah, maybe it's the flying saucer that I heard them talk about so much lately.
We have a special news bulletin tonight. Flying saucers have been sighted in various parts of the world. Over London, New York, and Cape Town. Even an old farmer outside of Tokyo claims he saw one.
Oh, thank you very much. Flying saucers are the sole topic of conversation. Gamera's lost his popularity.
Gamera was hit by radiation. Maybe he's dead by now. Anyhow, I wish he had been done away with for good, for the peace of the world.
You really mean everyone on the Chidoromaru was killed? And that the three of us are the only survivors?
Yes, my dear. It happened when we were at the Eskimo village studying the ancient carvings on that stone.
Doctor, there's something that I wanted to tell you. Before we started out for the Eskimo village, while we were still on board, the photographers and reporters drew lots for this assignment to see who'd accompany you.
And you're the lucky man who won the draw, right?
Lucky indeed. There were at least 7 or 8 cameramen along with us. They were not so lucky. All of them perished in the Arctic Ocean.
Yes. It was a lottery with human lives.
Oh. Excuse me.
One of those photographers made me an offer. A bottle of whiskey to exchange places. But I didn't accept it.
I guess running around the ice sounded a lot more interesting than staying on board, right?
Yes, that's partly it. Only I had something else in mind. Catherine, the real reason is that I wanted to be with you.
What?
You're the lucky charm of the expedition. Catherine, I'll always consider that you saved my life.
But you can't.
Yes, yes, because it's true. I'll always feel that way. You brought me luck.
Hello. Nice to see you.
I was actually coming to see you.
Is that so? Has Kenny done anything wrong?
Not really, but he's done a very strange drawing. I thought you should see it.
It looks like a turtle.
Yes. That's all he ever draws. He repeats it every day. A type of obsession. Kenny's not a bad student. Only he's very moody. He even has a little turtle that he carries everywhere.
Oh, no! He brings it to school with him?
Yes. He seems to cling to it. The other students make fun of him. They think that he's strange. I realize that Kenny's had a difficult childhood.
Yes, he's all alone. His mother died when he was very young.
I see. Anyway, tell him no more turtles, at least not in school.
Yes, I'll talk to him. Don't worry.
Bye.
That little scoundrel. I met Kenny's teacher today.
Oh, and what did he say?
That Kenny was quite an expert at drawing turtles.
When I was his age, I used to draw girls.
I finished eating.
Kenny? What are you doing with that? Who's all this food for? Daddy, Kenny's taken some food for his turtle again.
Kenny, I told you I didn't want that pet in the house anymore. It's making you neglect your schoolwork. Come inside.
Come on. I know how much you love your turtle, but there are other things in life just as important, like having friends. You don't want to live alone, do you?
Set that turtle free. Let him return to his natural home. It'd be better for you to forget turtles.
Kenny, if you get rid of the turtle, Daddy will get you anything you want, all right?
It's a promise.
Yes?
Tell me what you'd like best of all.
What I'd like best of all is...
What? Tell us.
To keep it.
Kenny, it's for your own good. If you don't, I'll throw it away when you're at school. And you know I'll do it. You'd better get used to the idea and get rid of it. I know it's hard, but it's really all for the best, right? And soon you won't think of it.
You understand?
Goodbye, Tibby. Take care of yourself.
Don't see anything? You're seeing things.
Kenny! Nora! What's going on?
Look, Daddy!
Thank you.
You're safe now. You're safe now.
Kenny, what is it? Wake up.
Ah. I was so scared. Gammera saved me, didn't he?
Yes. Gammera saved your life.
Because he knows I like turtles.
Gammera liked you. Gammera must have a good heart.
Yes. Gammera's a good turtle.
Yes. He is good. He is good.
Yes, he is.
Excuse me, Dr. Hidaka.
Yes?
Could you tell us what your next expedition is?
No, I don't know yet.
Will you be returning to the Arctic on another ship?
Dr. Hidaka is wanted on the telephone.
Excuse me, I must take that call.
Information desk.
There you are, sir.
Thank you. Yes, hello. Hidaka here. That's fantastic. Yes, I'll come right away. It's incredible. That was the university. Gammera has just been sighted near Hokkaido. Please arrange for plane tickets.
Yes.
Dr. Hidaka, may I?
I'll see you very shortly.
Dr. Hidaka.
More and more reports are coming in about the devastation caused by Gammera, though some of these come from unreliable sources. Gammera is said to be seen everywhere.
More about Gammera.
Does he disappear in one area?
Is Kenny sleeping?
Yes, he was very tired.
In a completely opposite direction.
You there? Tibby? 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 Tibby, why are you hiding? Now listen, I'll be back for you tomorrow.
Hi.
Alice.
How did you get here?
It wasn't very friendly of the two of you to give me the slip. Not polite.
Didn't they miss you back at your office?
Nope. I'm supposed to cover the Gammera story. My armband for the airport.
Catherine, you're still my inspiration. I'll follow you anywhere. Anywhere.
That's enough. What's the latest on Gammera?
Still not found.
They must find him soon, or there'll be chaos everywhere.
What's that noise?
I don't know. Maybe an earth tremor.
Try to trace it.
Sighted. Heading for the geothermal power plant. Come in, come in, come in. Gammera sighted. Come in.
Follow me. To emergency stations.
Careful. Don't get too close. Hold it.
Hello. How do you do, Commander? I'm Dr. Hidaka of Tokyo University.
Hello?
And I'm his assistant.
Who are you?
Oh, I'm from a Tokyo newspaper.
I'm sorry, but reporters are not allowed here.
Oh, excuse me, Commander, but this gentleman is a friend. He was on the Arctic expedition with us, and he knows a great deal about Gammera. I'm sure you'll find his presence and collaboration very useful.
Oh, I see. You can stay then. You can start.
Yes, sir. Yesterday morning, Gammera destroyed a lighthouse near this seaport. And right afterwards, it dived into the sea. Then it was seen heading for the geothermal power plant.
A geothermal power plant? What is that?
Allow me to explain. A large volcanic zone passes through this area, and high temperature vapors used to rise from below. By drilling through the volcano, we trap steam of 1,000 degrees centigrade and generate electricity with it.
You mean the steam actually reaches 1,000 degrees centigrade?
That's right.
Nothing could ever survive at such high-intensity temperatures. Don't you think we could use it to destroy Gammera?
I'm not so sure it's possible. Gammera has survived even after atomic radiation, and 1,000 degrees wouldn't affect him.
Dr. Hidaka, do you know of any countermeasures to destroy him?
No, not yet. What's the station's maximum capacity?
About 350,000 kilowatts.
350,000? There's just a chance it might work.
Commander, come in. Come in, please.
Commander here. What is it?
We're ready. Standing by.
Roger. Everything's set. We can attack now, Doctor.
No, not just yet. Maybe we can do it without a shot. It'll be a lot better for all.
You think we can?
Everything ready?
Yes, sir. There you are, sir.
Thank you.
It's approaching the wires.
Throw the switches. 100,000 kilowatts. Throw the switches again. This time, maximum power.
The electrical shocks don't seem to bother Gammera at all.
Incredible. It looks as if Gammera is even stronger than before, as if the electricity gives it renewed energy. Is that possible, Doctor?
It charges it like a battery. Commander?
Yes, sir?
I think you should attack now.
Yes, sir.
Attack!
Yes, sir.
Fire all cannons!
Commander, it looks like we failed. We must find a stronger weapon. I'll have to go back to the university.
Yes, but they...
Don't worry, I won't be away long, but I must consult a colleague. And in the meantime, I want you to evacuate everybody. Understand, Commander?
Yes, sir.
Good, thank you. And that's how things stand, Professor Morassi.
Our ancient legends did mention fire-eating turtles. But in the 20th century, I must admit it's very difficult.
But it's true. Gammera doesn't seem to have any weakness.
However, there is something I can't see.
What's that, Doctor?
Gamera's body must be stronger than metal. And if that's true, the situation is even more serious than we thought. It has the power to convert organic matter into inorganic matter.
Then that means nuclear weapons are totally useless against it.
Yes, that's it. The energy produced by nuclear explosions only seems to revitalize it, giving it unlimited energy resources.
Then what we must do is find some counterforce that will neutralize it, right?
And as for the markings on this stone here, I'm not sure they represent waves.
But the Eskimo said they were.
The Eskimo was only repeating old stories of folk tales. But perhaps these carvings can unravel a great mystery.
Commander, I believe we ought to call UN headquarters. We must use their missiles.
You're right. Contact them immediately.
Yes, sir.
Go, Gammera! Go away, Gammera! Gamera's good, he's good!
I'm Dr. Morass.
Sir?
Have you all your weapons in place?
Yes, sir. I guarantee that Gammera won't escape us again. We have even requested extra missiles from the U.S. forces.
Uh-huh.
Commander, all the missiles are in firing position.
Good. Start firing.
No, wait, Commander.
Don't shoot Gammera. Don't shoot Gammera. He's good. He's good.
Yes, it might be a mistake. Maybe we shouldn't use those missiles.
Why not? It's the only way to kill that monster.
Gammera is a creature that feeds on fire. Using missiles would not do any good, would only cause unnecessary destruction. No, don't use missiles.
I see. Sergeant, call it off.
Yes, sir.
Sir, thanks a lot. Gammera saved my life for me once. Gammera's really a nice turtle. Gammera is a good turtle, isn't he, sir?
Well, son, I just pray that you're right.
Commander!
What is it?
The plant is completely destroyed. The entire installation.
I see. You heard that, Doctor? Everything's destroyed.
There's nothing we can do against such terrifying force as that. Dr. Hidaka, is there anything else we can try?
There is one thing that has just occurred to me. Nature works in mysterious ways. Gammera is a creature that feeds on fire. It withstands great heat. I wonder if it would succumb to the opposite. I mean very low temperatures.
Temperatures below zero. Something like a deep freeze treatment.
Well, it is a method that we haven't used yet. This is still a military secret. But the Army has a bomb that can freeze just about anything.
You mean it can really freeze anything?
Yes. It was only developed recently. They tried it in the jungle to freeze all sorts of animals and plants. I think it's the best chance we've got left. Well, I think we should try it. Do you agree?
Yes. I see. Do you really think it might work?
It's worked very well so far.
In that case, we should use it against Gammera, Commander.
Yes.
There's one thing. It's only effective for 10 minutes.
Only 10 minutes?
It's still experimental, and after that, things thaw quickly. So we've only got 10 minutes in which to trap Gammera.
What happens if Gammera revives beforehand?
I don't know. It's a chance we've got to take.
Gammera has started moving. Gammera has started moving.
Gammera's moving!
We mustn't lose any time.
Yes, you're right. We've only 10 minutes, not another second.
Gammera has just started to head toward Devil's Mountain.
Roger. I just hope this plan's going to work. There's a resort town below.
We have to act quickly. Freezer bombs only last for 10 minutes. So we have to deactivate Gammera within that time. Is that clear? So be careful. If we make a mistake, the whole plan will fail. Gammera will wake up, and who knows what will happen then. So remember, we've only got one chance.
Dr. Hidaka, everything is ready.
Good.
Thank you.
What a picture! This is the scoop of the century!
You must tell us when to start.
Doctor, 10 minutes, beginning now.
Start! Start!
Looks like he's going to move again.
The freezing pumps are nearly set. They'll begin to go up soon.
How many minutes?
8 more minutes.
Hurry, Commander.
All right, everyone clear out. Let's go. Come on. Come on.
Let's get out of here.
Come on. Come on.
There isn't much time left. Dr. Hidaka, we must hurry.
Don't worry, we're ready to blast.
Back now.
Yes, but remember, Commander, turtles do not have the ability to turn over by themselves. So if we're patient and wait here a few minutes, it's bound to die shortly.
Dr. Hidaka, your plan was successful.
Yes, and if Gammera dies on that spot, we'll have a precious specimen, its whole body.
Yes.
Commander, look! It's pulling its head and feet.
You see, Doctor? It doesn't fly anymore. It's almost like a flying saucer.
Have you got the stone?
Yes.
Professor, the mystery is solved. The lines don't represent waves, but clouds. They were trying to tell us that Gammera was a flying creature.
Why, it's the same creature that I saw.
Oh, then the flying object you saw was Gammera.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, as the old saying goes, we see terrible things if we live too long.
Yes, it's true.
Oh. Are you hurt?
No, I'm all right.
Out of the way.
What are all these stones? Why are you carrying them around with you, Kenny?
I suppose this is another foolishness of yours.
Now, Kenny.
It's Gamera's new house.
Huh? Gamera's new house?
Tibby's from Gamera's family. Gamera has been flying all over the world. But as soon as it's sighted, it manages to disappear immediately. It's a shame we can't find exactly where it is now.
Yes, but let's be thankful it hasn't attacked any places yet.
Yes. Yes?
Hello. How do you do, Catherine? How do you do, sir?
Kenny, this is a pleasant surprise.
Yes, I told Kenny that when he was visiting Tokyo, he ought to come and see us.
Oh, good idea.
However, it is sooner than I expected.
Yes. You see, Doctor, our town had a lighthouse and Gammera destroyed it. And now it's been built again. Our house was destroyed, too, and now they're building that. So we decided to come to Tokyo to stay with an uncle of ours who lives here.
Oh, so you're a tourist now.
There's plenty to see and lots of monuments to visit. Do you see that structure there? That's Tokyo Tower.
Doctor? Is Gammera still in hiding?
Yes. But we're searching for it, Kenny.
Gammera must be terribly lonely. Gamera's really very kind. Gammera loves all children.
You know, Kenny has a vivid imagination.
Didn't he save my life? Gammera must be very lonely and must need friends. I'm sure he must be very hungry, too. Tibby's little and Gamera's big. Except they're both in the same family. I know it. I know they are. And they're both good and gentle.
Hello, Ikiro. You look very busy. I see you're still carrying those heavy boxes around. Any fresh fish today?
Fresh fish? Nobody eats fresh fish, just that canned stuff. And it weighs a ton, believe me.
Come back. Give me my stones.
Kenny!
You better give me my stones back.
I don't have your stones.
Yes, you've got them. I saw you steal them.
No, I didn't.
All right. Give him back his stones.
I threw them away.
Then you'd better go and get them, if you know what's good for you. All right. You heard what I said.
You see, I threw them off the bridge into the river.
Into the river? You little brat. Don't worry, Kenny. I'll get you other stones, just like those, all right?
There aren't any like those.
Kenny! He's crazy, crying over a couple of stones.
Shut up. Beat it.
Oh! It's all right, thank you. In a way, I'm glad he threw the stones away. Are you all right? Now, don't act like that, Kenny. You're a big boy. Sulking like that isn't going to bring the stones back again, you know? Kenny, there are lots of others there. I'll go looking, too. All right, Kenny? We'll look together. Kenny? Scoundrel, asleep already?
This is what we know so far about Gammera. First of all, he can withstand very high temperatures. And secondly, he's able to fly in the air by jetting fire. And thirdly, he has certain organs that function nearly like a hydroelectric plant and generate a mysterious energy. Here, we can see evidence of his tremendous destructive power. He can also set up magnetic fields that jam our radio communications. He seems to feed on coal and petroleum, substances that emanate flames to replenish his energy. The nuclear energy of an A-bomb, which is the most powerful energy mankind possesses today, may appeal to Gammera and could even be his primary target of attack. I can only repeat these words of caution. Gammera is a threat to us all, and if he is not killed, it could mean the destruction of the world.
Did you hear that? The situation is very serious.
I have here the final report.
As of today, the laboratory is holding 33,000 grams of uranium and 300,000 curies of isotopes. Gammera could instinctively be drawn to this energy and then head straight for this area.
Yes, maybe it's advisable to hide it in a special shelter.
We could use the copper mines. He might not detect it there.
Yes.
There's no load of fish today. We're going to have to go into another business.
Yeah, you're right. I tell you, there's something wrong with the water. All those nuclear tests, they're throwing the tides off.
It's those scientists. In a few years, they'll kill every living creature.
Yeah.
This afternoon, a series of floods caused by a reversal of tidal waves inundated Tokyo, devastating whole areas of the city. It's estimated that nearly 3,000 shops and houses were destroyed. We'll now show you film sequences. According to the communique of the Meteorological Observatory, the source of the flood remains a complete mystery, as phenomena of this kind are said to be impossible in this area. The authorities are now investigating the origin of the tide, which has also brought about a decrease of marine life along the Pacific coast. This problem will be dealt with in a special session of Parliament, as it may constitute a serious threat to the food supply. Furthermore, there were a number of collisions at sea caused by an interruption of communications as a result of the jamming of radio waves. However, this is still being studied by the experts. There's going to be a special conference later this evening at the university, during which Dr. Hidaka will talk to high-ranking officers of the Army.
Unfortunately, we are not yet certain what caused these catastrophes, though various theories have been presented by our leading scientists. However, if I may, I should like to give you my own personal opinion of the events. It is my deepest conviction that Gammera is the true cause of all these sudden disasters. For instance, it is quite possible that he may be hiding somewhere along our coast. And if that's true, then Gammera is what is undoubtedly disturbing the natural sequence of tides. And this could have been the cause of these recent floods. However, to investigate the case more thoroughly, we have invited leading scientists from all over the world, and they have responded most promptly to our urgent appeals.
I am sorry to say things are not encouraging. Every method used so far has not led to any concrete result. Gammera seems able to resist attacks by all offensive weapons known to us. Therefore, I am forced to admit there may be even greater catastrophes ahead.
Professor Morassi, before coming here, we attended a special meeting at UN headquarters, and they have recommended you're using a different strategy.
And what is that?
Well, they believe that you ought to put Plan Z into operation immediately, using the facilities you're building at Oshima in the mountains.
Well, that installation is still in the experimental stage yet. Using it on Gammera might exhaust its resources. Its main purpose is to advance peaceful scientific work, and it's really not designed for a military-like undertaking of this sort. And if we failed, it would set our work back at least 20 years. Furthermore, the facilities are not ours alone. This is a joint venture created with the help of the United States and the Soviet Union, and we would require their permission to use it for the purpose of destroying Gammera.
Canada Control Tower, please come in, please come in! Canada Control Tower! Canada Control Tower, please come in! Why don't you answer? Oh, look up there!
Thank you.
Wait, they're up! Hurry! You hear that? It's Gammera! Hurry, hurry! Everybody run! Don't you want to live? Get moving!
Ah, cool it, will you? Gammera doesn't scare us. We're not afraid of a turtle, are we? Come on, music, music!
Will you shut up? I said everybody out! Get out! Have all of you gone crazy?
Evacuate the city immediately. Everyone is to evacuate immediately. You are ordered to evacuate to the suburbs. Evacuate to the suburbs. Evacuate the city.
Excuse me, Dr. Hidaka. I think the Z-Plan must be supervised only by United Nations scientists. I realize that Gammera is very dangerous. However, we must insist on total control.
As for my government, I assure you, Doctor, you'll have our utmost support. Only such a dangerous plan must be supervised by the United Nations.
I understand, thank you. And I appreciate your help. My country will always be indebted.
There's one thing. We can't be ready for another 24 hours. And that's at the earliest.
The question is, what action can be taken against Gammera in the meantime?
Well, you see, as a zoologist, I believe that Gamera's violent nature stems mainly from a deficiency in his energy supply. Right now, Gammera is at a coal processing plant, devouring flames, its favorite food. The flames will die out in 8 hours, and at that point, Gammera will be in a much weaker condition.
In that case, to keep the risk to an absolute minimum, Gammera should be kept there for 24 hours.
That's right. And to do that, we must bring petroleum and keep the fires burning till we are totally ready with Z-Plan.
Every one of our storage tanks will be wrecked.
I understand. Okay.
Hold! Get going!
Right!
What is it? Did it work? Huh? Another tank. Okay, right away. All right. Another tank. They need another 24 hours. You better get going. Move it! They want to send another tank. Are you ready?
Yeah! All set!
Gammera?
You know, you nearly got us both killed. You better go home.
No! Gamera's my friend. He's good.
Yeah, I know, I know. Here, put this on. Go on. Go on.
Come home, kid. I'll say goodbye to Gamera for you.
Gamera's my friend, too.
He loves us all.
Gentlemen, I have excellent news. I am proud to announce that Z-Plan has been completed and is at your disposal. The world's latest technology stands ready for your struggle against Gammera.
The question is, how can we lure Gammera to our new installation located at Oshima? I'm sure it's quite obvious to everyone present that we will not be able to carry out our plan if we cannot get Gammera there.
Professor Murasaki, I have a suggestion.
Dr. Hidaka, please continue.
To make certain Gammera goes to Oshima, we must use special tactics. You see?
Right now, the whole city of Oshima is being evacuated. The city is off limits to civilians. Not even the press is allowed to enter the area.
Move along, move along. Well, it's goodbye for a while.
It's not fair. We've always worked together. Shutting me out isn't nice.
It's a pity they just don't want reporters along. But we'll come back soon.
Sure. Just the same, I hate being separated from my goddess. Well, goodbye.
Morassi is staying here. If you want news of us, contact him at the university.
Right.
Goodbye.
See you soon.
Has Dr. Hidaka left for Oshima yet?
Yes. He was on the very last flight.
I certainly hope Gammera goes to Oshima soon.
A visitor for you.
My dear, what are you doing here?
Professor, it's Kenny. I don't know where he is. I've looked for him everywhere. We were going to leave the city this morning, and then he suddenly vanished. You see, he was always talking about Gammera, so I thought that maybe...
Kenny, Gammera!
Yeah, okay. I got it. Sure, okay. The last load's just arrived.
Right.
Okay, they'll take care of it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That'll be the most effective strategy.
Let go of me!
You're coming with me!
Let go! Oh.
What's going on?
A stowaway, sir. A little boy.
A little boy?
Why, it's Kenny!
Here he is, sir.
You see, I was worried about Gammera.
Oh.
Kenny, you're a friend of Gammera, huh?
Mm-hmm. Kenny, let's go.
Well, it's time. Let's begin.
Dr. Hidaka, are you sure it's possible to bring Gammera here?
Of course. The typhoon's approaching. It'll be before then. Come in, please. This is Oshima. You can start Z-Plan.
Okay, set them down here. Take position.
Nora, I have good news. They found Kenny. He's in Oshima.
Oh, thank God. Thank God.
Yes, hello. Hidaka speaking. Hidaka speaking. The tanker has arrived. You're ready? You can begin.
Yes, right now. You may give the order.
Stand by. Take your positions.
Move!
You did it!
The plan's working!
Hidaka, Dr. Hidaka, Gamera's moving. He's passing right in front of us.
Wonderful. Gamera is heading this way.
Oh.
Hello. Hello. Yes, everything's ready. All right.
Is it coming? Is it coming?
Please be patient.
We bring you the latest news regarding the typhoon. The typhoon suddenly changed its course and is heading in a northeastern direction. If it continues on its present course, it will very shortly hit the Japanese mainland, causing untold devastation and destruction.
Dr. Hidaka, what shall we do?
There is nothing we can do but wait now.
Gammera! Gammera is coming! Gammera is coming! Gammera is coming! Gammera is coming! Gammera is coming!
For the story. I swear I really came along only to help you. I came by sea on that tanker there. I was worried about you.
But did you start those fires?
Yeah. Doctor, you must keep it burning. Make the flames higher. Gammera is drawn to fire. It will notice the fire and then land here.
Yes, yes, I see. It's a great idea. Come on, give us a hand. Give us a hand.
You did everything you could, Doctor.
It's no use. Lousy rain. Gammera is turning.
Later. There's no time now. I don't want to miss the Z plan.
It's fantastic.
Isn't it? I can't believe that we're really here.
Kenny! Hurry or you'll get left behind. We're going up!
Dr. Hidaka,
Professor.
Congratulations. A complete success.
Thank you.
Stand by, please. Stand by, please.
We're ready to proceed with Z-Plan. Start the flames.
The Mars rocket of the Z-Plan, constructed with the combined efforts of the world's superpowers, was successfully launched just now with Gammera imprisoned inside. We could not destroy Gammera on Earth, but the Z-Plan, the last hope of mankind, succeeded in sending Gammera up to Mars. It was made possible only by the cooperation of the member countries of the United Nations, proving once again that such great achievements can only be realized through goodwill and mutual aid.
Thank you.
And to you, Professor Moriarty.
Well, Catherine, I suggest you forget science and instead really become Alex's inspiration.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, Kenny, Gammera will be safe there. You happy?
Yes, I'm glad he wasn't killed. I'm going to be an astronaut and ride in rockets, and I'll see Gammera again, right? Gammera, see you soon!
Gammera was a large hit with Japanese and Western audiences at the time of its release, as Daiei Films released another 6 Gammera films after the first one premiered. All of those received their own dubbed version for the American releases. All of these are also in the public domain, and we'll perhaps take a canter through some of those in our next seasons. The film series also spawned a universally panned sequel in 1980 that was comprised mainly of stock footage from the first films. A series of 4 remakes with much larger budgets that received much better reception were released in the beginning of the 1990s. Daiei was one of the first Japanese studios to copy Toho's idea of releasing giant monster films using scale models and suitimation to make then-groundbreaking special effects on the cheap. Even large studios like Shochiku and Nikatsu began to feel the itch to put their monsters on the screen and people in theater seats. Join us again next week when we take a look at another 1960s sci-fi classic and watch the original 1968 version of George A. Romero's Night of the Living Dead. I'm George Roth, and this has been your Film of the Century of the Week here on Channel 5.